What's up, ladies and gents? I'm your host, CenterStrain01, and I've got a special video for you guys today. We are actually going to be playing Firewatch. Now, this is an indie type of game. I'm actually really excited to play this. I've heard a lot of great things about this as well. This is a game made by an indie, or kind of a only not so many members to the actual team to play this. So I'm doing something a little bit different, as this is a smaller game, and I've heard so many great things about it. I've seen a little bit of gameplay on it, and this is something that I'm actually really, really looking forward to playing. So I thought, you know what, why not give it a try? And since I've heard great things about it, we're going to play Firewatch. Now, I am setting up the stream right here, guys, so give me a few minutes, and then we're going to get underway. I'm really, really excited about this. We're going to be doing this for a few hours here on this first video. And, yeah, so hopefully you guys are going to enjoy. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter and on Twitch at CenterStrain01. That is where you're going to be able to find all the content that I do and to be able to, you know, stay updated on things like that as well. And we're going to get started here really, really quickly. So just give it a few minutes and we'll be underway. Underway. We'll definitely say that I am actually really excited to play this after just watching, you know, all kinds of footage for it that's been released so far. It just looks like one of those kind of games that I can really get into on the channel, and I'm actually really, really looking forward to this. So I think we're pretty much ready. We've already got over 50 some people in here, so thank you guys so much for all the love and support. We're just gonna get right into this. I normally don't do Let's Play, so this is blind for you guys. That way you guys can experience the story with me live, and hopefully, you know, if we get a lot of attention on these type of gameplays, then I could do a lot more. Still doing all the walkthroughs that you would normally see, but I do want to get out there and do more types of gameplay like this for you guys. So with that being said, we are going to do this. I am playing this, let's see, take out the graphics here, in 1080 on ultra settings. I played it a little bit earlier in 4K as I was testing things, but since I can't stream in 4K, I decided to do in 1080. And we are going to get right into this. So excited. Let's begin Firewatch. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You're a little drunk. So, what's your, you know, major? You slur the word major and it smells like Coors. You give an awkward smile. Evolutionary biology, she says, and I'm a professor. Cool, you reply. What's yours? She asks. She sniffs the air. Toxicology? Was that a burn, you ask? She says, definitely. Worried she hurt your feelings, she asks you if you want to split a cheeseburger. 1 week later, you were Julia's boyfriend. I really like how it just takes you right into it. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia is in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's bad ass. But we decide that we're going to pick up the beagle because it means so much to Julia. And we're going to name him Bucket. Bucket's a good dog, and a week later you've totally forgotten about the other one. Julia loves him. You kind of love him too. You talk out on the deck. It's summer, 1979, 9:30 p.m., and your heart still radiates off of the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Kids? They're not very smart, or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some. A couple of little idiots. That'd be pretty good. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, I would like that. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best that their parents are hitched. You're absolutely right. Thoroughfare Trailhead. First of all, I gotta say, you see your character. I mean, that's a plus in my game right there. Starting off things very, very smooth. 1980. It's a Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. You get mad. You call her an inconsiderate asshole. She tells you to off yourself and to not be such a baby. You call her selfish. She knows you mean it, and it hurts her feelings. 1981. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. You frolic like a Victoria's Secret model. Otherwise known as Victor's Secret. Mm-hmm. I feel like this type of game is going to be able to let my true personality come out a little bit. Alright, so it looks like we can run, but I just want to take a look. For a game that was developed by just a little bit over 10 people. Absolutely amazing. Nothing but good things have been said about this game, too. This is not your action-packed third-person shooter, first-person shooter. This is a game of experience. So it's 1982. During the summer, you and Julia enjoy walking Bucket at night. There's a festival in town, and it brings in folks from places far away. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Buckets gets kicked. Julie yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she is stressed. You confront the attacker. You beat his freakish face off. Your arms get cut up, but you beat the guy to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. You cry your eyes out before the cops show up. Julie asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say, okay. You don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. 1984. Plans to have kids have kind of been waylaid by work. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job. Associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. What do you do? I agree if she commits back and forth. You ask her if she'll commit back and forth. You don't want to make the move to Connecticut. She says that it'll be hard, but she'll do it if you won't move. You tell her not to pass up this opportunity if this is what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. 1985. Julia sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were very important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia, might be suffering from early onset dementia. She is 41. You both decide to keep it a secret for now. So pretty. Victoria's Secret model. Wow. Bucket is getting older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to the university. 1987. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She's devastated. She is sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days you get the Julia who calls you a dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days, you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family they're crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. 1988. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 week visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. You decide to move her into a full-time care facility. 1989. The game already has given you a really, really good connection with the characters, even with just simple text. And I applaud that. And I like how we're kind of making our way up. Her family agrees with your decision. You find a fantastic place in Boulder and move her there. You see her every day. Then every other day. You go out to the bar with your old friends. It's not the same. You get the feeling that every wife tells her husband, if you ever put me in a home like Henry did, I will cut your balls off. You slowly decide to not see your old friends that much. 1989. Julia's sister Susan moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter and urges you to use it if you won't see a therapist. You won't. You've always really liked Susan. Months go by. Bucket dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind, you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more and more. Summer is coming and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. This is Firewatch. Dun, dun, dun. All right, so enter the lookout tower. I keep seeing some text. Thoroughfare lookout, okay. So there must be something off in the distance. You slowly head up the stairs, wondering, is this the last stairs I'll ever head up? You see the place you're going to be taking a crap for the next couple of months. Looks real cozy. Beautiful landscapes, though. Let the game begin. Turn on the power.
Hello, Two Forks Tower. Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine. Then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
All right, so if you're watching on Twitch and it is buffering, you can always go over to YouTube and watch it live there. Remember, guys, I'm uploading at a very high bit rate, so if you have a bad connection, then it's probably going to be buffering for you on Twitch. But I got to get in those Twitch subscribers.
You're just going to leave me out on this? Ugh, fine. But I'm going to take a second here and have a guess about you. Let's see. I don't know anything about you, but 9 times out of 10, folks out here simply got dumped.
Is that it?
Close?
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job. Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
So unfortunately, because I was answering you guys, we missed out on an opportunity to reply, which would actually have been really fun because she's pretty fun to talk to, and she has a few quirky things to say during that conversation, but we missed it. Thanks, guys.
Hey, sorry, guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? Are those fucking fireworks?
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set him straight.
Do I write him a ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Secure.
Shut up.
Oh, this is going to be fun. I meant to pick this up and actually look at it. That's his wife and us. All right. Let's do this. I absolutely love the look of this game. Alright, so we need to locate. They said that it's west, so if we just go west, then we should be able to come across where we need to go. It has that that Valve kind of feeling to it, like Team Fortress. Like, I really feel like the graphics look a lot like Team Fortress.
I found the supply box.
Great.
The combination is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's a combination of my luggage. Go ahead and pick up the map.
Hey, I found a note to a guy named Ron from some guy Dave.
That's probably Dave Gaskell. He's completely nuts.
Is that right?
Armless, but yeah. One of those, you know, fall off the grid and eat ants for a week type. Totally fucking cuckoo. Which is kind of what the job attracts.
People just stuff these things with old food? That's how you get bears.
Those boxes are bear-proof. I wouldn't worry about it.
Alright, looks like we got the rope. We're going to continue on heading west. I love these type of adventure games. I think a lot of people call them walking simulators. I'm like, a game doesn't have to be all action-packed for you to enjoy it. It can have meaning, it can have substance by being very simplistic and linear, and still get a very enjoyable experience out of it. Just depends on what type of person you are, and you know, if you can accept that.
Hey, there's a tree out here that's been ripped to hell.
And?
Don't you think that's, you know, like, disconcerting?
Henry, there are 500-pound grizzly bears out here. They sharpen their claws on trees.
We don't have grizzlies in Colorado. People killed them a long time ago.
Well, in the thoroughfare, they hunt people, they kill people, they bury their bodies, and then come back weeks later to eat them because they prefer rotten meat. People just disappear.
Don't you think that's disconcerting? This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
Yeah, well, I'd go with Widowmaker.
Come on, it's really not that bad.
It's a 50-foot cliff made of rocks that look like knives.
They just look like knives, okay? Plus, there's already a Widowmaker on the backside of Carter Mountain. It would be confusing.
How do you expect me to get down this?
Well, did you get that rope?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, just lash it to something nearby and take it slow.
Hey, I'm going the right way if I'm at the shale slide, right? Toward the fireworks?
You're not lost. Those fireworks are going off to the west of you. It's down the slide and across the meadow, okay?
No!
Yeah, Steam notifications are off, and I am reading both Twitch and YouTube. I'm sorry for the buffering on Twitch.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
Widowmaker got the best of me.
What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Be careful, for Christ's sake.
Remember, we're going to keep heading west.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
They left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
The idiots down at the lake?
Yeah, them. I just found where they're hanging out. Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans, they threw them all over hell.
Are you fucking serious?
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
But I left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
Uh-oh, things are getting interesting.
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
Balloon fight contest.
There are panties.
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why? Because you're 12?
There's a. Ooh.
Yes?
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies, same as anyone, but there's, you know...
Two?
Yeah.
I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy, enjoy dealing with that.
You gotta take it easy with the fireworks, all right?
You ought to take it easy at the Sizzler buffet. Chelsea, what? He's just some loser out in the woods. I mean, he's grody.
Hey, just so you're aware, I confiscated your fireworks.
Our fireworks? What? Dick!
Also, setting off fireworks out here isn't just stupid, it's illegal.
Yeah, so is stealing, asshole. That's so fucking bogus. You're gonna pay for that.
Can we just move out of here?
Fine. Hopefully there won't be any more trouble.
Good. Thanks for going down there.
Hey, there's a trail to Two Forks Tower down here near the lake.
Yeah, that's your tower.
So I should go this way.
Well, you're not climbing back up that slide.
My motherboard is an Asus Formula 7, and I have a i7 4790K. GTX 980 Ti and all that jazz. Alright, so it looks like we're just heading up the trail here. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. It really does have that Team Fortress kind of look to it. I'm really digging it. Can you dig it? I love the colors in this.
I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe?
I gotta say, I'm really loving the way this game looks.
I found a flashlight.
There's one in there? Great. Well, the sun's gonna go down soon, so if the batteries still work, you're in luck.
There's a horn or an antler or whatever.
Well, antlers are made of bone, and horns are made of the same stuff as your fingernails.
I guess this is a bone.
Antler. A ranger must have found it this spring.
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
Hello? I bless the rains down in Africa!
Gonna take some time to deal away from you. There's nothing that 100 men or more could ever do. I love that. One more time.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
That's too bad. I used to go caving in Colorado a lot with someone. Would be really nice to pick that back up.
Fond memories, huh?
Big time. I'll keep an eye out for those keys.
Don't hold your breath.
I think they consider this a mystery game, you know? So there's like a mystery to be solved. It's your life for the summer or something in the park or whatever, and yeah, I'm really interested to see where this story's gonna go.
There's some guy out here.
Some guy? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. People come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
Wow, look at that. Man, it's so beautiful. It's amazing what you know, developers can do these days with so few people.
Ugh.
Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but, you know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime. Ah. I don't think there's any fictional character I hate more than Forrest Burns.
Henry, as an employee of the Forest Service, that is treason.
Yeah, well, he really freaked me out as a kid.
He inspired me to spend the bulk of my 30s keeping the wilderness safe.
A shrink would have a field day with you.
Thanks, Mom.
So this generator is all the power I've got out here?
Yep. It doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with frizzy locks.
I could never. So it's, just the outhouse, then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want. Well, number one, at least. And, full disclosure, I pee wherever I want as well.
I'm such a bad man. Alright, let's get back in there. It's starting to freak me out a little bit when it's getting nighttime. Hold on.
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell...
You should get inside.
Fuck me.
Oh, now it's starting to get a little freaky. Oh, someone ransacked the place.
Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since... I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I've done it before.
Okay, tough guy. Up. Hey, wake up.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
Can you see the communication wires from where you are?
I can see the poles, but I have no idea if the wire's in good shape or not. They run a good distance up to a spot called Beartooth Point. You just need to walk along them all the way up there and make sure everything's in ship shape.
So I've noticed that you only have a very short amount of time to reply, and some you have like a timed where others are not timed, so I'm going to try to make sure I pay attention to those that are timed, because there was a Henry thing that we missed there.
You wake up pretty early then, huh?
As soon as the sun comes up. Forest Service really frowns on us putting up curtains for some reason.
I just covered my head with my pillow. Seems to do the trick.
Wow. The forest could never burn down on your watch.
So there's a previous reply, a next reply. Okay, I got it now. I see what that means. Alright, looks like we know where we're heading. We got to go back down to where we were. See what kind of mischief we can get ourselves into today. So this is where I have to ask myself, which way do I want to go? Zoom in. Widowmaker, medicine wheel, two forks, lookout. Thunder Canyon. So maybe there is a way to get there from here. So if we go left and then take the right from where we are right now. That's weird because it doesn't orient which direction we're looking at. So if I need to go west. That's right, we'll just retrace our steps. I know we can go the other way too. But if we go out to Jones Lake, then we can catch up the other side. Ooh, look at the fog.
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
Oh, see, it's we got a...
I don't know. I used to just spend a lot of time with our dog, Bucket.
Aw, that's a good name.
He was a good dog.
What type?
A beagle. We got him from the pound.
That's great. Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you? All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Bucket's a cute name. You owned him with someone?
That would be my wife, Julia.
Oh, like your wife? Or like she's taken half my stuff wife?
My wife.
But you're here.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
I'm at the shale slide. I can't climb down from here without a rope.
You shouldn't need a rope where you're headed. The climb through the canyon has its dangerous bits, but you should be able to do it without gear.
Which way is the canyon again?
It's just north of your tower.
My tower. Which way is that from the shale slide?
Oh, that's easy. It's a straight shot eastward.
Thanks.
Okay, so it's telling me to go back the other way. I was going to go to... So it won't let... Okay, it won't let you go down that way and then back around. Show. I guess we are going to have to... I wanted to take that one. I like this because this is going to be, like, hilarious. Trying to figure everything out on where to go. I like how it's really open. Alright, so let's see if I can get it to do what I want it to do this time, which is take this little route here, which is a little further up. Alright, see, now it should just be a straight shot here. You can see, but this is... No, it's not cut off. Then again, it is cut off, so we'll let me take this one. Yeah. Maybe I need, like, an axe or something in order to do it. Alright. Alright, so we'll go back the way we came. Yeah, so we have to make our trek through there, which is kind of weird. But that's what we gotta do. Alright, so if this is the outhouse, then it should be right here. Although this is a little different. Or is it? No, this is right. Yeah, I'll be definitely a full-time streamer a little bit later in the year when I actually get out of the military. As of right now, I'm still full-time military, so this is still just a part-time thing for me. And then once I finally am able to do this full-time, I'll be able to put much more time and effort into everything that I do, which is going to make the channel better. Obviously, yes, I stream in the highest quality possible, which makes it very hard for a lot of you out there, but I do that because I'm actually streaming both simultaneously on YouTube and Twitch, and this video is directly going to is directly being uploaded to YouTube right after this is done. I don't know, is that... No, it won't let us do that. And since it's doing that, the quality is very, very high, but if you don't have a good internet connection, you're not going to be able to watch it on Twitch, because unless you're a partner, you can't change the quality options. And I upload at 6 megabytes a second. So being that high just is murder on Twitch. But I still, stream to Twitch mainly because I gotta build my audience somewhat there. And for those that can watch it on the higher setting, you know, it's tricky. Alright, so I made it back in here. We just need to find the correct route. Alright, so we are here at the cave, but I don't see anything else Yes, I am watching the YouTube live chat, Andreas. Maybe where I'm supposed to be is not in this cave. Or maybe we have to follow something about, I remember something about cables. There's just so many different spots that you can go to. This is so open-ended. I feel like I've already got lost. North of the canyon. Yeah, so it'd have to be... I'm heading in the right direction. I just want to make sure I don't miss anything that I'm looking left and right here. Follow the lines, I guess.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it. Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
I mean, I'm in the right area?
Yeah, the wire runs quite a ways north. Just follow it up to the point that I mentioned.
So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just... seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
Wow, I never realized how big. Whoa, look at this, man. It goes all the way there. Up. Where in the heck am I going? There's like so many different directions, but I want to follow the main wire, right? Which is up there. And this is a dead end, so yeah, I guess we do have to go back the other way. Oh, we got a supply box.
Whoa, I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise. It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
It's actually pretty cute.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Now, what do I call it? Looks like a,
Oh, this ought to be good.
Turt Reynolds.
Well, now I can't wait to see him.
The mustache is impressive.
You tell him I love Cannonball Run.
Who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Look what we found. Can't report on it though. Someone had left a book under there though. Alright. Let's pick up our search again.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
I wonder how much stuff you can actually hold.
Hopped down a drop and now I can't climb back up.
That is a pickle.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
How adventurous of you.
I've been doing a lot more climbing out here than I expected.
Well, keep your radio charged. I'd hate to one day find a skeleton with an orange backpack at the bottom of a ravine.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around. Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it the moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I'm gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Alright, so there's our tower, obviously. So we're going to be a good little worker and clean up this area a little bit. That's just another way to get to where we were before. We did a little exploring. Beautiful. Supply drop is 60 feet. There it is. Oh, it looks like we got nothing in here. And there's nothing out here. All right, so it's time to head back. So let's take a look at our map. See where we are. We're all the way up here. We go down, breaking point. Okay. They said they could have cut back down to the lake.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Oh, I guess we do have a rope. I thought we didn't have a rope. I was gonna say, we don't. Who needs a rope? You should be able to just... Really? So we can't get down here. Even though it looks like that would be an easy thing to do. And we can see that right there. You know, game logic sometimes. It's just kind of how it is. But we don't have a rope. I guess we have to find another one. I don't see why we couldn't have detached the rope to the one area. Would have made a little bit of sense. Alright. So we're going to head back. We've done a little bit of exploring. We know we can't go that way. I do like how this game is just not straightforward. It's definitely a game where you have to think. You have to remember where you are, where you're going. Use a little bit of your brain. And I love games that make you use a little bit of your brain. I am also noticing there's a lot of frame stuttering. Ooh, what's this? Alright.
Hey, I'm out at a ravine. What's this thing that spans across it?
That is how you get to my sector.
No kidding. Well, let me hike over.
Well, it's locked up and mainly for emergencies. I've never actually used it. Rangers use it from time to time, but that's it.
Help! Oh, God, it's an emergency!
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got eyes on a tornado! I gotta get out of here!
A tornado in the heart of the Rockies?
Yes!
Holy moly, I need to call this in! Tom, Two Forks sees a tornado! He says he needs an evac into my sector. It's a meteorological impossibility? There haven't been tornadoes in the greater Yellowstone region in 100 million years? You're gonna need him to stay and take a detailed personal account, even if it means giving his life? Okay, I'll tell him. Sorry, Hank. No dice.
Man.
That's oh, right, Strain misses things every now and then.
That pack was full of them. In decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah, it was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so, you know, our love could never really be understood.
Ugh.
I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. That part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. It took off halfway through the summer.
You guys keep in touch, you and the Goodwin kid?
Nah, they took off pretty unceremoniously. Plus, what's a 40-year-old woman gonna do with a teenage pen pal?
Good point.
Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know, I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
So we got another note. Hello, Dave. It's like a total mystery here. I love this.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
Maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
All right, so we're not too far away. We got Jonesy Lake. I think that's where we're going to head. He said they might be heading back to the lake.
What does she have? She's got Alzheimer's, like dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
We were scared shitless. We went straight to the doctor after her first spell or whatever. They diagnosed her and we were both just very scared. Can't really tell when Julia is scared. She just gets quiet. She was very quiet.
That's a really a sad story.
Hey, Delilah?
What do you got?
Delilah!
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain link fence?
A chain link fence?
Yeah, it looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh, that's weird. No idea about what's going on with that.
Do you think those girls could be behind this fence?
Well, having once been an ornery young woman, the last thing I would do is climb a fence. Especially if I knew I was in trouble.
I don't even know how I would get in.
It's really strange that that's out there, by the way.
Yeah, it's weird.
All right, so where are we heading? Let's keep going this way. This is a long second day.
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point. No one would camp out in the fireweed. Well, I want you to stay out there, as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail.
So I guess we'll just kind of rummage around, see what we can pick up. I mean, it's open, but it's not really too open. It's very linear, so I would imagine it wouldn't be too hard to get lost, or it would be a little hard to get completely lost in this.
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Oh, man.
What, you like that? This guy is the freaking king of the flapjacks.
Yeah, that's solid. I'll have to keep that one in my pocket.
It's all yours.
In a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I walked over and asked her what her major was because I thought she was a student, not a prof.
Smooth.
That's me. I did make the first move, though.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
Another way down there.
Wow, I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing. I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
All right, so we're going to go up because it's up, which means we need to keep continually heading up. See if we can get to where our destination is. Follow the big smoke. Thank you again to everybody out there watching me live. I appreciate it. It means a lot to me. You guys are awesome. I do plan on doing more of these live streams. I'm just not really big on live streaming. Especially being a walkthrough specialist, which makes it a little bit more difficult to do live streams. When you're doing walkthroughs. I love the music, though. Oh, we're back here. Look where we are. I didn't even look at the map to see exactly where we were. We did make it back here.
What are you going to do when the fire season wraps up? Are you going to go be with her? Just go back to Boulder? You should go be with her. That's my opinion.
I don't know. I haven't really thought about it. Right now, I'm trying to hunt down some vandals, and I don't even know what I'm going to do when I find them. I'm not thinking very far ahead.
You should go see her.
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents... I think they always thought she could do better. And that I could have done a better job looking after her. We meet again, Widowmaker. You haven't beat me yet.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to Five Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
That one is actually pretty big. I didn't think it was going to be that big, but... did the smoke go? There it is. So there's no need to go down, right? If we just... Unless we're going to come to a dead end and it won't let us go forward. Yeah, it looks like we're coming to a... to a dead end this way, so we're probably going to need to... go back the other way. That's right, we're back to the campfire where they were before. Yep. And I don't think there's a path this way. All right. No, maybe there is. That would be no. All right, so let's get back to where we were before and we'll take that rope. I'm really, really like, my mind and concentration is really in the game, so I do apologize for not looking over as much on the stream. Man, he must have really had a lot of rope. But this should cover everything now. We should always be able to get back to other places. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the Assassin's Creed Chronicles Russia walkthrough as well. And I will keep that going strong. Alright, we got another supply box here.
Hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Well, at least I know we're heading in the right direction. Ooh, look at that sun.
Waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
So I'm gonna weigh in on what I think about Hitman and the whole episodic thing. I feel your guys' concern. I'm a little concerned as well. I can understand why they wanted to do it. Square Enix had huge success with Life is Strange, so I can understand, you know, why they wanted to see if that would work.
I see it. Campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. These girls have a full case of beer left here, a full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines.
Alright, so we need to hunt and track them down.
Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back. You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say? Hello?
Oh.
Henry, are you there? Honestly, I'm just
glad wouldn't let me pick it.
Probably the best case scenario for us, and now we can just get back to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
All right, day two complete. Find boards downstairs to patch windows.
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Oh, is that so?
Women say that we have a similar musk.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you asked.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Tuxedos, as often as possible.
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
Good to know, Dale, yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They're steely, cold hard stare.
Like a Siberian husky.
Sure.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
All right, so I got boards here. That's what I'm trying to find. Is this the boards that I need? Are these the boards that I'm looking for? I guess not. I guess they're over there. Yeah, I was thinking those are the boards. And here they've been all around me. And one more right there.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and, I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
I'm actually really excited about what Kojima is going to be coming up with.
Nice afternoon?
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. If they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset. Henry, wake up.
Oh, here we go. It's gonna get scary now.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
You sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
I don't know. There's some weird stuff going on.
Oh, that's too bad.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
That is weird. What? I feel like this is The Shining.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
What do I think about game trailers shutting down? I am actually very upset about it.
2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night. You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I am.
Good. I'm glad. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. He's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. I've just lied about it for over 10 years. And, for some reason, I wanted you to know. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Looks like she's finally opening up to me. So it says, do not take the other ones, so.
Alright, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Thanks a lot, Sharon.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
If I was there with you, I'm sure I would like it a lot.
Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but I want you to know, well, maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer. Look, we don't have to plan or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk without these radios. We could, you know.
What? What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
Oh, jeez. Wow.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Does problem actually mean murderer? Like how Charles Manson is a problem cult leader?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks. That's it.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah. Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
I would. Okay, maybe gotta put this away. There, okay.
What the... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry? I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that.
All right, so it looks like we're heading back to the canyon here.
found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
We'll get it if you...
Holy shit!
I got hit in the head, punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you. This just seems like a misunderstanding or something.
There are people listening to our conversations. The person or these people were hiding in the bushes down here. What the fuck, Dee?
I don't know, Henry. This sounds crazy.
Yeah, and you're not the one who just saw our words on a clipboard out in the middle of nowhere.
Those words were from 2 weeks ago.
I'm hiking through the canyon. Which way is my best bet for getting to Wapiti Meadow?
It looks like you can find a trail on the north shore of Jonesy Lake, towards the west.
Thanks, Dee.
I should be able to go forward and use the trail that we did before. This is really, really picked up.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No, nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
It's nothing, I promise. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry...
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Oh, I went down the wrong one. There's another one that I missed. Damn. I mean, there is a way to get there, but that would take so much longer. So we're gonna go back. Now there should be something. Yeah, we keep going this way, then we'll see a left and a right. It says we can go because it's lit up that way, so. Should be right up ahead. But I don't see. You see what I'm saying? There's like a... Oh, yeah, I know exactly where I am. Right, that's the big one that we saw there, because you could just, I think, barely see right there that we would need to get all the way up there in order to go that route. And we never went this route before, so therefore we actually can't. I really like that, though. I like how that... I'd have to go all the way back to get down to there, just to get back to there, and it would not be any better. So I'm gonna make my way all the way up, back around to the fence. If only there was a way to get back up there, but we can't like throw the rope up there. I do like how you have to really think about these. So I just want to make sure that there's... We can't do this, whatever this is here, because you saw that right there. It looks like that might be another rope section right there. So we would need to, yeah, gotta go the long way around. Just taking in the sights. So if we follow the wires, just like we did before. Probably not gonna let me. Yeah, there's a gap there. That's right, we can't go this way though because of this. Yeah, this is a survival type of game, more of a mystery than anything. Like, you're just trying to figure out what's going on, and... Alright, we can't get up that way. We would have been able to get there a lot easier if we would have put a rope in one of those spots that we were. Mm-mm. There's got to be a section over here that's going to let us go to the left. Here it is. Hold on just a second. I apologize. All right. He will not, the guy in the chat will not be able to say those stupid things anymore. Once I become a bigger streamer and I stream more often, then obviously I'm going to have more mods in there to make sure that none of that stuff happens, you know? Alright, so let me get back on track here. We need to go straight up to the right. There it is. So glad we made it. Alright, so it said we need to be near the fence. Is there like a specific section? Huh. This was where we needed to go, right? Let's see why I wouldn't just climb over it. Do I have, let me see, explore, alright, it's up by here, that's right, so, crap, well, we can't really get there now, can we? Can't seem to move forward. So we'll continue on this path here. Yeah, hey guys, I don't know. The game doesn't give you tells you where you need to go, but it doesn't help you in any other way now. There was a gap to the left. I saw this little gap here too. This looks like you'd be able to climb underneath, but you can't. Yeah. So I am not sure. God, you think you just sit there and climb that right there? Come on. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what to tell you. Something that would seem very, very easy to accomplish. Maybe we gotta go back this way for some reason. Unfortunately, I can't speak with Delilah. Even when you look at the fence, there's nothing to show up. So, I'm not really sure. Because now we're just heading back. I mean, wouldn't that just... Yeah, it looks like we're just going to have to head to the lake. So, go straight back down. I guess the lake somehow is going to get us there. We'll see. All right, keep heading straight. Yep, this must be the correct way. It also wouldn't have a saving point right there. And this is exactly where we were before. Remember, we couldn't get up there because of the rope. So, I wonder if we could have got there from the lake from that very, very beginning. We could have saved ourselves a good 20 minutes. This is day 66 or 63 or something like that, I think. What do you know? We didn't have to go all the way back, did we? Nope. Could have took this right here. This will probably get us there. No, the character cannot jump. Everything is contextual.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it. Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Okay, I've given it the good college try. No dice.
Shit.
How about jump over the damn fence?
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
All right, so something about Ruby. Look for a controlled burn in Ruby Lake. That's Jonesy Lake. Campfire smoke. Is that all the way down there? South of Ruby River. What? We gotta go all the way down there. I don't even see how I'm even gonna get there. Oh, there it is, so. And that looks like what it would be. You think? All right, I'll try it, guys. I'll try it. It's a long shot, but that might actually work. Man, that's why I love you guys. You guys are way smarter than me. But then again, you're not. Let's try another one. Nope. Not gonna work. I gave it a shot, though. Because I love you guys. Looks like you'd be able to jump. Nah, I guess it's too big. Alright. We're heading towards the fire. We didn't start the fire. There was a bigger rock? Oh, please. I'm not even gonna listen to that. There was a bigger rock. Find more rocks? I don't know if I should... You know what? I'm just gonna go. I'm gonna follow the smoke. You guys are tricking me. I like to listen to you guys, but sometimes you gotta know when to say enough's enough. you hear that? I thought that sounded like a man. Alright. No more getting distracted here. You guys see that?
Whoa, the June fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
There was an axe? Okay, now you're killing me.
I'm wandering around east of the lake. Which way is Ruby River?
It's in the southeast corner of your map. The scout camp where the firefighters were staged should be on your map. It looks like a little triangle with a flat bottom.
Yeah, it looks like a tent.
How did I never see that before?
Why am I listening to you guys? All right. Alright, so everyone is saying that there was an axe in the crate. Do not go back. I've got... You guys are just tricking me. Eventually, if there is not an axe in this crate, that I am no longer going to be listening to any of you. So, we're going to find out. Okay, I don't know if I'm blind or... I, for some reason, don't see an axe. There is no axe. I am done. Listen to all of you. You have lost your turn. I am done with you. I am done with chat. All of you are fired. It's the last time I listen to them. I'm going to listen to YouTube after the video. What are they saying? They're probably all making fun of me right now. But you guys know me. I listen to you guys. I'm actually one of the few YouTubers that actually listens to who... he plays games with. I don't play games for you. I play games with you. That's why I like to look at it. There was a small compartment. It looked like it because of the lighting. Sure there was. Okay. Should be the right way because we're heading there. Yep. You know, you're right. I could have used the book. The book is way stronger than a rock. What am I thinking? I also want to know if you guys would like to see me play Unravel. I'm also going to be taking a look at the Homefront beta. So there's, you know, lots of things coming up on the channel here shortly. Okay, we need to get over there. There's got to be a little path. Yep, there's another stream path here. And it's blocked off. It's the way we like it. I am going in a completely different direction. I should not have taken that little down. I think I need to head back. Yeah, that's not going to work. We need to go over by the Ruby River. Yes, I will be playing the open division beta. If I'm going to play it on PS4, I don't know. But my guess is the direction that I'm going in right now is not going to be able to get me over to there. But I'm not in any hurry. I like exploring. It's fun.
Hey, what's to the south of here?
Mexico? Is this some sort of riddle?
I just have a nice view to the south. You know, trees and mountains forever.
Well, eventually you'll wander into the area overseen by Chimney Rock Lookout, but that's probably an impossible hike in terms of terrain.
Alright, so we got a long trek back. This lake tricked me. I left the bow? No way. We gotta go back and get it. Something that almost looked like a cave back there. I'm just waiting for there to be some guy to hit me on top of the head when I get up here. Very impressed with what they have done with this game. Alright, where did... There is the smoke. I know what it is. I need to use the typewriter to type my way out of it. To type like a key that fits the lock. You know, this is like this is Alan Wake mystery, you know. We write our own story. Okay, so the June fire.
Right?
Yeah.
You don't think he could?
No, you're probably right.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Wow, there's an old, I think it's called a medicine wheel out here?
Yeah, it was made by Crow American Indians hundreds of years ago. There are lots of small ones. Have you ever been to Medicine Wheel Monument over in the Bighorns?
Well, I sure haven't.
Well, it's worth a 3-hour detour on the way home in August.
Neat. I'll keep it in mind.
Was it a 3-hour tour?
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to two forks now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
What kind of play are you in the mood for? For play? Perhaps? See what it did there? Nobody? Ah. Cricket, cricket. I'm talking to myself here. Alright, you're not letting me go left. I'm running into something here.
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
Whoa, someone stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
And that's weird, right?
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
Camp Arapaho.
You're there?
Yeah, I am.
It's been out there since the 50s.
I was never really into the idea of the scouts. It's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Never sat right with me.
Beware weebelows in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers. The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
There's no going down there. Excuse me, I'm gonna sneeze. I apologize. Possibly here, no jump across. That's a dead end. It seems like you'd be able to. There's so many things I could do as a human being that I would do that the game won't let you. Like right here, I'd go across. Thank you. And it would be so easy. Here's another spot that I could easily jump. Okay, it wants me to do a long drop. Totem pole. Surprised she doesn't have anything to say on that.
You ever talked to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
I mean, he wasn't a scout or a weeblo or whatever?
I got the sense that boy could barely tie his shoes, let alone a clove hitch.
What the hell's a clove hitch?
Well, it's a knot that you are probably too old and too stubborn to learn. You use it to make rafts and shelters and stuff like that.
Huh. You know how to tie one?
Heck no. I'd make a weeblo do it.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
There are bear traps out here, in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up.
It's really wanting us to take the long way around, and we're gonna have to go all the way back. Jeez.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss. Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Oh, you know, probably just horned toads.
Maybe Turt was an escapee. And a Wapiti Station clipboard with our conversations on it is just, what, recreation for them?
I'm just messing around. Somebody is obviously up to something. I'm freaking out here.
At least we know there is something real happening behind that fence.
I think that we should consider that maybe this is all just a coincidence, but my gut says that there is something bad going on.
Mine too. Okay. So what's next?
I'm gonna do a scan for supplies and then figure out a way to get back over that ravine and hike towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Ooh, I wonder if you would see somebody, like, following you. That'd be very interesting.
I've got an overgrown trail here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
So I'm screwed when it comes to getting past it?
Mm-hmm. Screwed until you clear it yourself, yeah.
Great. Well, if I come across some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing list of responsibilities.
All right, so let me see. Where am I going? Return to Wapiti Meadow. Really? I don't have what I need to get in there. So don't even tell me that was a wasted trip. How am I even going to return? Alright, my guess is we're going to have to go the right side that we didn't. Right, is it this? I'm gonna say no. Alright, so I am trying to think right now, guys. If there's a way that it's going to even let me over. If I had an axe, damaged. Yeah, we could chop down this tree. There's got to be. Oh. I knew I was probably missing something. Sometimes it's good to figure these things out yourself. See, now I see it.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
Sweet. Timber! Hold on. Alright.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough? There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout, could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Holy shit!
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The June fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
Alright, so this is where I am actually going to save my game and end this stream, guys. Hopefully you're enjoying, and don't forget to let me know in the comments below on the uploaded video after I'm done with the stream. Let me know that you guys want to see more of Firewatch. I want to see where the story goes from here, so more than likely, I'm actually going to continue it. But I gotta say, I'm having such a blast playing this, and I hope you guys are enjoying it as well. If you think that this is a game for you guys, go pick it up. It seems like it's pretty fun. You can change some things around. You remember in the beginning, the stories that we chose, you can act differently towards Delilah if you want to. It's all up to you guys. Some things can change about. But really want to thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it again. Thank you so much. I know everyone's like, no, but I've got so many games to put out, guys. We've got other stuff that we need to do. I've got more Assassin's Creed to do. I want to possibly think about maybe doing some Unravel videos. There's Alpha Protocol. We have got a lot of stuff on our hands. We've got a beta coming up for Division, and we've got a beta coming up for Homefront. So lots and lots of videos. I think this stream has been going on for about 3 hours, so I think 3 hours is a good enough video. I want to make sure people will actually stay and watch. But again, guys, thank you so much. Don't forget, when the video is uploaded, do me a solid, like the video now, share this with your friends when it becomes uploaded. It would really help this channel out so much. That is something that all of you guys out there can do to help me out. This is our channel, and I've always said that, and it really is, but we all have to be active and a participant into making this channel grow more and more. And I promise you that who I am is never going to change, that this is who I am, and you're kind of stuck with it. So hopefully you guys can accept that. But again, thank you so much for watching, of course, and I will see you next time. Peace out, bitches. We'll make sure it's saved, though. Okay. Bye, I'm Claude.